Hi, I'm Tara Hitchcock, and you're watching Harkins Theaters Behind the Screens. Today, it is Chaos Walking, the latest sci-fi adventure starring two of Hollywood's biggest stars, Spider-Man himself and Star Wars actress Daisy Ridley. Tom plays a man living in a world where a virus has become fatal for humans, mainly women. The remaining survivors can hear each other's thoughts. Tom stumbles upon Daisy in a forest after her ship lands on his planet, and it goes from there. Behind the Screens had a chance to Zoom with Daisy and the author of the book the film is based on, screenwriter Patrick Ness.
Whoa, whoa, stop, don't come any closer.
It's a girl.
Girl.
Oh my gosh, girl.
You know, it's funny, I was reading an interview that you did where you were talking about what Ray might have been up to or what she might be up to now that that whole thing is over. And your comment is running around in a forest somewhere. And I thought, you know what? That's exactly what you're doing in this movie, running around in a forest somewhere.
What is she thinking? Where the hell is her noise?
I mean, wouldn't we all love to be running around in a forest somewhere? That's what I say.
Well, with Tom Holland as well.
Yeah. I don't think many people imagine running around a forest with Spider-Man.
You call it the noise. Happened to all the men on this planet. Every thought in our heads were on display.
You know what I realized watching this movie? To be honest with you, guys' thoughts aren't that interesting. I mean, in the entire movie, they're trying to convince themselves or portray themselves as more independent and confident than they really are, but their thoughts aren't that interesting. Is there a guy that you know, maybe one that we are familiar with, whose head you'd like to poke around in, who you think might actually have some interesting thoughts?
Interesting. You're the first person to say they're not that interesting. It's funny. It's true. It's true. They're not that interesting. Intimidating.
No offense.
Yeah. Yes, but uninteresting. Not really. I like the fact that I don't have to hear what other people are thinking. We have closed minds. I think also as like a person, I love it when you like get to a point where someone like reveals something else about themselves because they feel like safe and calm and like a conversation. I think that's so beautiful and so revealing of people and what people choose to share versus, you know, to one person to another. I just think that's a wonderful aspect of human nature.
Well, and you don't want to get that glimpse too early. You want it to be authentic and natural, just
exactly
like you mentioned. It's interesting. When was the last time you kind of wish you had a filter? Like maybe you embarrassed yourself a little bit too much or just, you know, God, I could have used a filter there. Probably shouldn't have said that out loud.
I don't do that often. When was I actually embarrassed the other day? I can't remember what happened, but it was quite rare for me to be embarrassed, but I can't remember. It was so silly. I haven't said that
pretty
much.
Good.
Plus, it's actually helpful with masks now, because I think for the most part, if people say something, someone goes, "Huh?" and you go, "Oh, yeah, it's fine. So you don't have to repeat yourself, you know?
Is that a problem, boys?
Do you have a mantra? Speaking of repeating themselves in the film, Tom he constantly says his name. He needs something to get his focus and filter out some of the noise, make sure people don't see it. Do you have a mantra that helps you kind of quiet the noise per se?
I literally say to myself, it's all right.
Aww.
Like, yeah. I think just
you
like,
meditate?
It's all right. Do you know what? I should meditate. Like my brain is like, and I think I should. I find meditation and other things like training for me is meditation and reading for me is meditation. I definitely should do like more legit meditation. But just saying it's all right. It's all right. Just being, particularly now, I think everyone just be easy on yourself. Like it's all good.
How many are coming? 100. 200.
In the film, you've got this dangerous thing in your purse or in your space bag. What's the most dangerous thing I'd find in your purse right now?
Oh my God, I don't actually have a purse now because obviously keys.
It is the first day of shooting. There's an eclipse.
I would imagine for you, this feels like this has been a long time coming because you guys started filming this how many years ago?
Initial photography was 2017. We'd always planned on additional photography. That's how this director works. It's how all of his movies have been made.
Sure.
But we had the weird circumstance that our two lead actors then were in the biggest movie franchises of all time. So getting a schedule after that turned out to be a lot trickier than we expected. But it's here and I'm very happy that it's here. So.
Not only that, during that time, were you sitting back going, oh man, the timing of this is perfect. I've got Tom Holland and Daisy Ridley, who were somewhat, you know, relatively unknown at the time. And now, obviously, as you mentioned, huge.
Well, all credit to our casting director, I think. And also, because I mean, it holds true of Cynthia Erivo as well. You know, since then she's had 2 Oscar nominations. So a very, very, very clever and intelligent casting director. I think it was amazing that the more famous Tom and Daisy got, I'm like, this is incredible. Right. This never happens. So.
Yeah, I think that's my only complaint with the movie is it would have been so great if Cynthia had had a musical number in here just for added kicks.
In the middle of this serious sci-fi western, why not? Yeah.
I'm watching the ones.
Snake.
Cocky little son of a
snake.
You know, I was so curious to see how they would visualize the noise, because you have in your mind what that looks like and what thoughts look like. How much of a part were you in how to visualize that?
Well, I really try. Just separate from screenwriter, I always thought my goal as author was just to try to be helpful and friendly, you know, and not, you know, my baby, not that kind of thing, you know.
Right.
And so I just would try to really say, this is how I saw it. This is why I saw it that way. This is what colors mean. This is, you know, really the chaos of it. And that conversation about how to see the noise was by far the longest, because it's the most important thing, and it's never really been done before in this way. But my favorite little scene of it is Daisy Ridley's walking up a hill and Tom Holland is walking behind her, and he's kind of grumpy about her. And you see all of those grumpy thoughts just flying up the back of his head. And that's perfect to me. That feels like a dream. Like, that's exactly what I want. So, yeah.
Well, and there's some great, I mean, the comedic elements of that, which is so fantastic of, you know, are you scared? Nope, I'm not scared. But, you know, you can hear what he's actually scared, which just made me laugh. There are so many really good comedic elements about that. In terms of the noise, are you the kind of guy that prefers chaos and noise, or do you really appreciate silence?
Really appreciate silence. Chaos. Okay. A world with noise would be a nightmare for me. I like my quiet very much.
So how do you filter it out? Because in the film, it's funny. By the way, what I learned is that guys' thoughts aren't that interesting, Patrick.
Well, kind of nobody's is, are we? I mean, I think they're, you know, because we carry around this way of describing the world so that we can be sane in it. Right. And it doesn't look very sane. It's a functioning machine that we then filter. And without a filter, it's just chaos walking, as they say in the film. So a little peace and quiet in a quiet house with, you know, quiet meditation app sometimes, I'm good. Yep.
Do you have a phrase, you know, in the film, Tom's character constantly repeats his name. He's got to have something to focus on, a mantra to kind of make sure that nobody can see his noise. What is that mantra for you?
Mostly, the thing I find myself saying most of all is I'm good. And it's just kind of a way to get people to stop asking you stuff. I'm good. I'm good. Yeah. I'm good. And so I don't do that on purpose, I think. And I only just realized it now, but that is what I say all the time.
They made me promise I'd make it here.
You know, the timeliness of this is kind of interesting. We all ended up kind of having to take a forced moment of silence, or at least almost a year of silence or a pause. But what do you hope comes of this in terms of audience?
Who knows? I mean, there are, you know, going to be lots of ways to see it, I hope. And, the world feels like it's opening up a little, and it feels like we're looking for something to take us away from our place. And I think the movie is about people in a really difficult situation that they didn't expect and how they kind of overcome it. So, I mean, I hope that that's what people take away, because I think it's a really hopeful film despite some sad stuff.
In it. Be quiet. They're trying,
Come on. Fight.
So you can catch Chaos Walking at Harkins Theaters now on the big screen where it's meant to be seen. Hey, don't forget to like us on Facebook, Harkins Theaters, for your movie news, promotions, giveaways, and we'll see you at the movies.